he might win the Vezina. He's been that good and has carried the mail here for the Vegas Golden Knights most of the season, with Robin Leonard been injured a little bit early in the season.
Got the kill. And got the tying and winning goals before regulation ended. Smith got it across, and there was Martinez from the same spot from which he scored on Monday night. This time he didn't get all of it.
Saw this play a goal from the other night. Once the puck goes through the box, it makes it much more difficult.
Spurgeon holds. Minute left in the power play. Spurgeon to Johansson, who moves in. Goes cross ice. Rask off the post. And Petrangelo cleared.
Great play by Johansson a few minutes later. Had to corral it a little bit. Puck goes up on end.
Ian Cole scrambles down from the line. Behind for Foligno. Goes off the back of the net. Up front, a chance. Cole had it blocked by Kolesar.
And then Cole slides down on the back door. And Cole does get a shot on net. And Marc-Andre Fleury does a good job.
Three at the drop of the puck. Almost flashbacks to the old Ryan Carter's days when he was playing for the Devils.
That's right.
Rask for Spurgeon, and the Wild gets set up. Bonino with it. Across. Rask center. Johansson, one shot, two shots. And Fleury makes the save.
On the back door, a left shot, thinking that this was going to be a tap-in. Great save by Fleury to get his pad on the ice, and then to stay nice and low to be able to handle any rebounds. Keeps both pads flat. Nice play by Bonino to find him on the back door, and if there's anything laying around there, right there.
Johansson gains the zone, gives it to Rask. Across for Bonino, moving in, a shot saved by Fleury, rebound! Kaprizov had a look, and Fleury's able to cover.
Few looks here by the Wild on the power play. Nice job by Bonino. Earlier he passed the puck on the back door. This time he decides to throw the puck at the net, and Kaprizov is hanging around trying to chop the puck in there. To show the coach that I can't play, but not Kirill Kaprizov. He's ready to go.
And we're underway in the second period. Kaprizov with a shot that went wide.
And that puck was up on edge. I saw it jump on edge right before he hit it. If that puck would have hit the net, those are tough to stop for goaltenders. Just misses the net.
Janmark able to pick it out of the skates of Dumba, and they score. Stevenson beats Talbot. Dumba could not control this puck at the Minnesota line, and the Golden Knights make him pay.
Get a turnover at the blue line again. We talked about the outnumbered situations. The Wild have done a much better job in this game. That's the first real 2-on-1 we've seen the whole game. And Stevenson catches that one clean and beats Cam Talbot right up over the glove. And the Vegas Golden Knights draw first blood. That was deflected, I believe, by Marchessault downward, and Talbot made a huge save.
Carlson got it through Marchessault, and a save by Talbot,
who scored 30 goals in this league. A quick little 2-on-1 at the top. Marchessault comes around, and they take advantage of this 2-on-1, and he's got this puck on his forehand. Most guys want to go to their top glove.
Ducks around a check, tried to throw it back for Rask, and it's taken away by Kolesar. Now the Golden Knights have numbers. Carrier to Kolesar, a shot kicked out by Talbot, and a big save on the rebound against Carrier.
Kolesar, who got shut down a couple times by Cam Talbot earlier in the year when he had one goal. Remember, we were going to say, is he this guy ever?
Parisi carries to the corner, and Janmark exits for Vegas. Back to Stone, gives to Stevenson. Stevenson drags it around. Suter centers for Stone, and what a save by Talbot!
The puck out on his backhand to Stone. This is against the grain. Talbot moves to his right and flashes the leather to his left. And look what I found. A bit of a breakdown to have Stone in there all alone.
Got it back. Feeds to Soucy, driving the net. Soucy centers. Loose puck. Johansson had one whack. Two. Fleury down. And the puck goes to the corner.
Not recklessly. Great opportunity to get to the front of the net. Carson Soucy tries to stuff the puck around. It's just loose laying in front. Vegas Golden Knights looking for sticks to tie up. Do a good job of keeping that puck away from the Wild forwards, and his defensemen can keep that puck out of harm's way, and they do exactly that.
Spurgeon fires off the post. Fleury never moved.
Close in the first period. Jared Spurgeon jumping in on the back door. Fleury doesn't see the puck at all.
Kaprizov intercepts. Wild would have been offside, so he has to play it back to Soucy. Now back ahead to Bukestad. Bukestad swings wide, fires, saved by Fleury.
Side post, and Nick Bukestad tries to go up high. Fleury does everything he can to try to fight that one off.
Spurgeon holds, back to Kaprizov behind the net. Hartman tangled with Carlson. Zuccarello tried to go across. Zuccarello again. They score! Kirill the thrill one more time.
Most rookies go away. This guy gets better, has played better as this game has gone on. And I mentioned this earlier. I had a feeling that he was going to score a big goal. And Zuccarello tries to throw this puck at the net and Kirill Kaprizov. I don't know if he got a stick on that. That's a pass. I don't know if he got a stick on it or if it hit his shin pad, but oh, he got it out of the air. Are you kidding me? Kirill Kaprizov is back at it. Good for you, young man.
Golden Knights come away with the puck. Dumba gets walked by Theodore. A shot and a save by Talbot. Rebound loose. Dumba scoops it up and leads the charge. The Wild have numbers at center.
Pounds that one past Fleury. We've got a tie ball game.
They score right off the draw. Kaprizov again. It's his 26th. And the Wild are in front.
All right. I think it's safe to say you can put Kirill Kaprizov's name on the Calder Trophy for Rookie of the Year. This guy is making a statement. There at Dallas, but Robertson as the Rookie of the Year. But I think the way Kirill Kaprizov is playing here, a loose puck off of a faceoff. Again, look at the footwork, how he's able to two intent. He pulls it to his forehand and quickly shoots it over his shoulder. What a huge goal here in the third period in such a big game and a big moment in this season. That's about five blocks on this kill so far for the Wild. Might need one more.
Martinez with it. Toward the net. Blocked! And Riley Smith scores. The power play goal 1 second before Zuccarello returns. And Vegas has tied it 2-2.
Blocked the shot, unfortunately, for the Wild. It went right on Carlson's stick. And he just pumped it over to Riley Smith, who scores a very big power play goal for the Vegas Golden Knights to tie this game up. The Wild laying it out there had five or six great blocks.
Off the draw, puck comes free to the line, Talbot the save, and he just swept it away from Petrangelo at the horn. What a stop by Cam Talbot.
Stevenson is not, I would not be surprised to see the Wild start with this puck.
Eriksson-Ek wins the draw, back to Spurgeon. Pacioretty scored the winner that night, he's not in the lineup tonight for the Golden Knights. Strong play by Stone. Able to separate the puck from Eriksson-Ek. Stevenson in. Saved by Talbot. Rebound Kaprizov. Johansson with Rask and Brodin. Johansson cuts to the middle. Drops to Brodin. Cuts right in and his shot deflected over the top by Fleury. Johansson trying to catch up with the play. Petrangelo didn't get anything on the one-timer off the feed from Marchessault. Tuck to Petrangelo. He scores. And the Golden Knights make it a perfect 8-0 in games decided in overtime this year. And the Wild will have to settle for 1 point after entering the third period down by one.
Again, a little given goal by the Vegas Golden Knights. Alex Tuck, who come off the bench and was fresh as a daisy right here from this pass from Marchessault, is able to fake a shot on net, freezes Cam Talbot with the fake, and then Cam unable to get over to his right. And the Vegas Golden Knights escape with an overtime win here in St. Paul.